Parents, day one of the Say Nothing Challenge is finally here. If you haven't pledged to be part of this challenge yet, you can still do so. It's not too late. There's a link in the bio or there's a link above this post. Just click it and join the literally hundreds of parents. It's mind-blowing. Hundreds of parents who have pledged to say nothing. And what it really means is they've pledged to be intentional and have self-control. That's what we're talking about day one of the challenge. If you're part of the private Facebook group where you pledge and then you clicked through to be part of the private Facebook group, you're getting all of this information that I'm sending out. So you already received an email from me about this. If you haven't done that yet, make sure you do it. But being intentional and having self-control as a sports parent is really the first and most important thing. I had a parent email me this morning and say, you know what, Andrew, I do send my kid motivational quotes before games. And I do sometimes give them pregame reminders. But from this day forward, I'm gonna do it with the intent to just make them feel better and to lift up their spirits a little bit. And I'm not gonna do it with the intent for them to score more goals or play better on the field. Because that's where we can get in trouble. If all we're doing is trying to get our kids to perform at their best and to not make mistakes or to do all these things, that's the wrong intention. I think having intentionality with why you would do something like that is the key. So this challenge, yes, in this challenge, there's guidelines, right? There's these five or six guidelines. They should be above this post. And they're meant to help change the way you do things as sports parents, change the way you think. But essentially, if you want to give your kid a motivational quote and they enjoy it, that's great. But make sure you also ask them, hey, Johnny, do you like it when I send you these quotes? Do you like it when I give you pregame reminders? And let them decide if it's good or bad. Having self-control as a parent, I get it. I've been around the sports world a long time, and I know, like, you feel those feelings of frustration or embarrassment or man, my kid's so much better than that. Why aren't they giving their best? Why did they slow down? Why did they get beat by that kid that's not as good as them? You get those feelings, but having the self-control to not let those feelings turn into emotions and then those emotions turn into actions is honestly just the focus today. So when you are intentional, you can have self-control. That's how these two things marry together. In order to have self-control, you must first be intentional with your actions. So pause for a minute and just think about, what kind of parent do I want to be? What kind of sports model, what kind of figure do I want to be for my kids? And I think that is the key, guys. So again, click the link, join this Say Nothing Challenge if you have not already. Guys, this is just day one. We've had so much feedback. I love you guys for being a part of this. Thank you so much for your humility and vulnerability in this process of really learning something new. So thanks for watching, guys. Please share this, tag somebody in it, and we'll see you tomorrow.